Hello, welcome to Finance Speaks. I'm your host, Kyle Sadler, president of Precept Wealth Management and best-selling author of I'm Retired, Now What? I received this email last week and I wanted to share it with you, even though I realized when received it was really a vague topic. However, the reason I want to share it with you is because it brings up a topic of conversation that I would like to address. So, here's the email question that I received. I am a teacher in the state of Texas. I understand that I'm eligible to retire when my age plus years of service equals 80. However, what I really want to know is how many years I need to have before I can retire, and is there any way of retiring early? Wow, because of multiple facts presented, that it's a tough question. Therefore, my response to this person was that we needed to speak further because I needed to gather additional information. However, for the purpose of this video today, I want to answer that question in a way that at the end you'll understand exactly why I need to gather additional information, and that there's a retirement planning need that you should complete prior to retirement. Okay, let's look at the facts, the hypothetical facts here. Let's say that this person makes $60,000 a year and lives in Texas, who has a retirement calculator factor of 2.3% for each year of service. Well, after doing this calculation, I can pretty much tell you that for a person under this type of pension plan, they would need approximately 36 years of service to break even with their current income. This is just a break even and be able to enjoy their current standard of living. However, more and more pension systems are moving into a no COLA era. COLA meaning cost of living adjustments. Therefore, yes, right now retirement is in their current standard of living, but as I've discussed in other videos, we have to be aware of inflation and that pensions with no COLA will not keep up with this inflation. I won't go through it due to time constraints, but here's the math. So let's just trust the fact that I've been doing this for going on 19 years now and know the solution. So let's look at the math. Okay, that's the math behind the statement. Let's look at the question, or just the simple fact of what having additional savings can do for someone. As I said previously, inflation will occur, so a retiree should always have additional savings to offset inflation. Therefore, the first amount I would recommend is that if a retiree has 36 years or more of service and they fall under that example that I gave previously, they should have at least an additional $100,000 in savings. However, if a person would like to reduce the 36 years needed just to break even, a simple savings plan to reduce the number of years is for every additional $100,000 a person has over the original $100,000, they can subtract 2 years from the 36 years we discussed. Here's why. At a 3% distribution rate, the average person would yield approximately $250 per month. Whereas using the information I previously spoke for salary and retirement factors, the 2 years of additional work experience would yield approximately $230 more in their pension. Therefore, we are close to the numbers of additional work years versus savings yield. So, what does this mean? If someone has an additional $500,000 saved up for retirement, they could essentially retire with 28 years. Again, based on the example I used previously, and maintain their same standard of living as what they have currently. $100,000 to assist for inflation risk associated with a pension, and $400,000 to reduce the service credit needed to fulfill the person's financial support by 8 years. So, the moral of the story is that the more that you save, the sooner retirement can happen. However, I want to remind everyone that we're talking just about your savings. You cannot look at this and go, oh, well, my spouse has $500,000 in their 401k, so I can go ahead and retire. No, that is their money that will offset their retirement. Planning has to be done first on an individual level. After individual planning is complete, then planning can be assessed on the couple's level. So, back to the person in question and how I handled it. I had to call the individual back and ask, and we spoke and ended up meeting that so that I could gather more information about their personal situation and personal assets. Prior to wrapping up, I would like to also share with you the same warning signs I shared with her. First, retiring too soon can feel great now, but be aware that expenses later in life may demand higher income or savings. It's harder for an 80-year-old to find a job than a 55-year-old. Second, she must maintain a budget that is within the means of her income throughout retirement. Not just the income versus expenses matchup now, but also the income versus expenses matchup in 20 years. Third, not having enough money in savings to assist with inflation, medical costs, final expenses, etc. Fourth, making a decision based on emotion and not based on a well-defined plan. I just can't take it anymore. And not showing up is not a good idea. Pre and post plan the transition. Five, for married couples, not defining and discussing a decision that will affect the entirety of both of their lives. See, the hard part is that in the financial realm, there are no blanket answers for everyone. However, with what I discussed today, this should be a great tool for assisting in setting a retirement date and savings goal. Each person will have to do their own individual needs assessment, so I highly recommend sitting down with a financial counselor to personalize your plan. Everybody has their own risk tolerance level for investing, time horizon, and financial needs. Therefore, to have a more accurate way to determine your exact plan, professional assistance should be sought. So, to conclude this video, I want to remind everybody that friends don't keep secrets from friends. So that means, don't keep me a secret. Referrals are the highest form of flattery. So I want to thank you for watching our program. For additional financial videos that may be important to you and your financial security, please like, subscribe, and share. Also, don't forget to visit us at www.preceptwm.com for more information and guidance. If you should have questions or concerns about this video or any others that we have produced, please don't hesitate to contact us. Have a suggestion for a topic? Please, I would be more than happy to shoot a video because I know that you are not the only one with that question. For Finance Speaks, I'm Kyle Sadler. Headed out until next time. Have a blessed and spectacular day.